This is Lake Luzerne in the southeast Adirondacks, probably one of the prettiest spots you'll find on Earth. It has everything, mountains, streams, lakes. It is God's country. I'm Jim Mandel, and I'm both a summer resident and later became a year-round resident of Lake Luzerne. My family's been here for 6 generations and have been fortunate enough to enjoy this area. I wanted to give back to the area, and I had a dream. My dream was, after visiting a school on a canoe trip in northern Minnesota, to create a similar school here in the Adirondacks, one that would both keep alive the traditional arts and crafts of the region, help the local artisan, and be something that the town could be proud of. I hope you enjoy the Adirondack Folk School. It is part of my heart.
I had just a great love for the Adirondacks since I was a child. I was the fourth generation of my family to spend every summer in Lake Luzerne on the lake, enjoying the swimming and canoeing and what have you. And so there was also a part of me that wanted to give back to the town. And finally, I struck upon the idea of a folk school. And that's because I had been out on a canoe trip. I used to do a lot of wilderness canoeing in the boundary waters. And there I had come across the North House Folk School at the end of a trip. And so at that point, I said, gee, that would be a great thing because there's so many unique things to the Adirondacks, so many crafts and so much art that is only found there. I'd spent years going to the Adirondack Museum, which is now called the Adirondack Experience, but back then it was called the Adirondack Museum. Every summer I'd go up there and spend many, many days and just be fascinated with the furniture, the rustic furniture, the birch bark picture frames, the pack baskets, just the beautiful workmanship. It's sort of unique.
How did you sell the idea, the concept of a folk school to folks around this area?
It was an easy sell. I had spent my career in marketing and business and design. So I made up a questionnaire and asked people, I would sit out in front of the post office and ask people, I had an idea for starting a folk school. So I said, what would you like to have? You could either have a folk school or you could have a bar or you could have some other terrible thing, you know, a place where you could buy drugs, hard drugs, whatever. And every time the folk school would win and nobody knew what it was, but it would win. So I went to the town supervisor and said, look, we've got 90 some percent of the town would love to have a folk school here. So with my hard data, I said, that, you know, we should do this. The two main things besides myself was a great set of volunteers and Gene from the town who was behind us the whole way. The volunteers were, I reached out to another young lady that I had known or a woman that I'd known there, Sue Wilder, and said, I've got this idea. And also Sandy Sherman, who was a volunteer up at the Double H Ranch. So from the time this, we worked almost a year to get the town to agree to the building. And then once we got it, within 9 months, we opened for the first class.
We wanted the school to be an inspiration to people. We wanted them not to just come and say, well, I learned that. I wanted them to say, I learned how to do that. I did it. And I can pass this on to someone else. And you know, it was a love of learning. So we wanted to inspire their hearts, their hands, and their minds to make this school move forward.
We started with the short-term leasing, and now it's 11 years later, and it has grown 20 times the size that it even began, or even we all thought it was going to be. And we're happy, and I'm really pleased that I was way back involved in it and really kind of helped it. Be a mentor of it, and that's the way I enjoy working with the people here. The leadership has been great the last 4 or 5 years. And you know, when you go into a place and they make you want to just hug them that they're doing a great job, that's good for my job.
But that building sits just on such a beautiful piece of land at the confluence of the Hudson River and the Sagandaga, the last untouched by man spot on the whole Hudson River, from there north to the headwaters up at Mount Marcy, all the way down to New York City to the harbor. That's the last spot that hadn't been dammed. And that's the natural waterfalls behind the school there. Such a gorgeous spot. So I had a vision that we could have hiking trails in the back there, and we have classes and days where they'd make a kids and their a parent. We wanted to have them combine, make a hiking stick, and then they could take their stick on its first hike out through the woods and identify some of the trees we'd marked and a lot of things like that. But when it started to catch on, and people would see if somebody walked through town with a pack basket, that was pretty cool. Or we had a giant chair. Somebody else had a friend make a giant, big Adirondack chair, which is unique to that region again. And somebody else donated a trailer, and we stuck it out front, and we were able to take that and tow it to different events and display it. And we put a sign on about the school, and it became a little bit of our advertising and promotional venue. I made a list of all the things I wanted to make first, all the things that I'd always wanted to make. And then I asked Sue and Sandy what they think that they wanted to make, what things would they have liked to have learned. And we put together the birch bark picture frame, which is a classic from the Adirondacks, and pack baskets and all kinds of things like that. And that list was the beginning of, okay, these are kinds of classes I bet other people would like to learn. And so then there was another lady, a friend of Sue's that we met, who was a teacher at the community college, taught photography. We came up with this idea. We called it 50 artists within 50 miles. We were trying to, as part of the goal of the thing, was to set it up and support the local artists, starving artists that are really have a tough time making a living just selling their art. So we thought, gee, this would be a win-win. They would be able to teach and make a few dollars teaching, pass along their love of their hobby or craft, and then also help the school by offering the class that we wanted to teach. We've just had tons and tons of people come, from music to painters, wood carvers, whatever. And that's also how we got the first wood carving class, was that other program. Wood carving came from that, and the Shades of Nature class came from that. A few others, wood turning, things like that. So that's how I got started. We get people to come take a class, and they would tell somebody else how much fun it was. We did a lot of free events during the summer at the fire ring. We had people come and talk about birds of prey, and we had another blacksmith come and do a demonstration down by the fire ring. We had sing-alongs. We had music people from the Adirondacks, well-known people that volunteered their time and show all the equipment and all the things that were being made, and we started display cases of things that the students were making. And that got the word out. Three founding principles was to support the local artists, to keep these crafts alive, and the other part was to be an economic engine for the community. So to keep it alive, we needed to bring people in. There's just, and that's kept the gas stations alive and the restaurants alive, you know, camping spots, you know, the state campground and the B&Bs and things like that have all profited greatly from the folk school. The other key to it, I still believe, is the location. There is no place in the world like the Adirondacks. You can be right from the door there, paddling whitewater rivers, you can paddle placid lakes, you can do hiking in over 4,000 feet in the high peaks. It's an area that is just breathtakingly beautiful.
The Adirondack Folk School was a dream of mine. This region, this Lake Luzerne, and the school have part of my heart and my soul, and they'll be here forever. I hope you can come and enjoy the Adirondack Folk School and take part of it home with you. It is truly a remarkable place.